Hello, I'm Jean-Paul Walensky, professor of neurosurgery at Northwestern Medicine. I specialize in craniocervical junction abnormalities, tumors of the spine, particularly primary tumors of the spine, and complex myelopathy. When you think about the anatomy in this area, this top bone is C1, and then this is C2. The odontoid sits right behind C1, and this yellow represents the brainstem. This is the normal relationship for patients that don't have any of these anomalies. In patients with cranial settling, what happens is this odontoid, the C2, starts pistoning up through C1. So actually the base of C2 can be as high as C1 right here. Traditionally, what we would do to get to this area, because if you see this skull sitting right here, in order to get to the odontoid, we'd have to open the mouth, go through the mouth, go through the C1 arch and remove the odontoid. If patients had such cranial settling where the odontoid was much further up than C1, tucked in behind the clivus, then what we would have to do is not only open their mouth, but split the jaw in the middle, open the jaw so that we could work through the jaw, move the tongue out of the way, and then get to the back of the pharynx, open up the pharynx, and then take out C1. The bottom of the clivus in C2. In this approach, going through the endoscopic approach, what we're doing actually is the patient then is lying on the operating room table like this. We place a tubular retractor coming through an anterior cervical discectomy approach at essentially the C4-5 level, angling up to the base of C2. When we're looking down that tubular retractor, we're seeing really that C2-3 disc space. Now, operating like this would be super uncomfortable, so we bring in an endoscope as well. So the endoscope allows us to have a beautiful visualization of that area. We're looking up through that endoscope up at C2, and then we bring a drill, or in this case, a bone ultrasonic device to remove the bone, and remove the bone from C2 up along the anterior aspect of C2. Behind the C1 arch, up to the odontoid, and then drilling that down from the top down until all that bone's been removed. And that's the ventral approach. The posterior approach is the standard approach, coming back from the back of the spine, placing a plate on the skull, lateral mass screws or pedicle screws into the spine, and rods to connect that area together. And in the case of this patient, we also did a suboccipital craniectomy and C1 laminectomy to decompress this region further. Bone graft is also placed then to allow us to produce an arthrodesis between the occiput and the cervical spine, which will then halt the progression of this from the future.